polynomials.apscourses.com. Let's have a look at the topics that shall be covered in this video. We shall start with roots of a polynomial. Then we'll move on to the properties of roots, and we'll finish with division of polynomials. Let's start with a small recap of polynomials. What is a polynomial? A polynomial is an expression of two or more terms consisting of variables and constants. What is the degree of a polynomial? Degree is the highest power of the variable. So in this polynomial, x to the power 6 plus 3x square plus 4, the degree is 6. Let's start with the first topic, roots of a polynomial. P of x be a polynomial. P of x can be anything. It can be x square plus 5, it can be x cube minus 3x plus 2, and so on. It can be anything. The value of x at which P of x is equal to 0, that is called the root of the polynomial. So if P of x is equal to x square minus 4, then x is equal to plus minus 2 are the roots of this polynomial. The graphical representation. This is a graph. It intersects the x-axis at minus 2 and 4. This graph cuts x-axis at x is equal to minus 2 and x is equal to 4. Hence, at these values of x at minus 2 and 4, y is equal to 0. Hence, minus 2 and 4 are the roots of this graph. Let's look at another graph. In this graph, it does not intersect the x-axis. Therefore, at no value of x is y equal to 0. And what is y? Y is the value of the polynomial. Therefore, this polynomial has no roots. Let's look at another graph. This graph has 3 roots. Making a graph, let's make a graph. Draw the graph of the polynomial x square minus 4x minus 5. It is given that y is equal to x square minus 4x minus 5. You start making the graph using a table. So make a table for the values of x and y. This is your table. Assume few values for x. Let x be minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. You'll get the values of y accordingly. You have the values of x and y. Plot these values on your Cartesian plane. You get this as your graph. The next example, draw the graph of the polynomial x square plus 2x minus 3. Again, make a table of values for x and y. Take a few values, x is equal to minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And you get the values of y accordingly. This is your table. You plot all these points on your Cartesian plane. And this is your graph. At x is equal to minus 3 and equal to 1, the value of the polynomial is equal to 0. Graph of degree n. A polynomial of degree n can have at most n real roots. Hence, it can cut the x-axis at a maximum of n points. Let's have a look at the graph of a cubic polynomial. This is the graph of a cubic polynomial. It cuts the x-axis at 3 points. It can never cut the x-axis at more than 3 points. That will never happen. Sum and product of roots. This is a property of roots that we are studying now. We shall start with the case of quadratic equations, equations of degree 2. If this is your equation, ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, and its roots are x1 and x2, then the sum of roots is minus b by a, and the product of roots is plus c by a. Notice the alternating signs. The signs are minus and plus. In the case of cubic polynomials, let's have a look at the sum and product of roots. If ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d is equal to 0 and its roots are x1, x2, x3, then sum of the roots is minus b by a. The sum of products taken two at a time is c by a, positive c by a, and the product of the roots finally is minus d by a. Notice the alternating signs. The signs are minus, plus, minus. So they keep on alternating. Let's look at a fourth degree polynomial. If ax to the power 4 plus bx u plus cx square plus dx plus e is equal to 0 and the roots are x1, x2, x3 and x4, then sum of the four roots is equal to minus b by a. Sum of the roots taken two at a time, there are six combinations possible for four roots, this is equal to c by a. The sum of the roots taken three at a time is minus d by a, and the product of the roots finally is e by a. Once again, notice the alternating signs, minus, plus, minus, plus. Let us consider an example. Find a quadratic polynomial whose sum of the roots and product of the roots are minus 3 and 2 respectively. It is given to us that minus b by a is equal to minus 3 and c by a is equal to 2. Let a be equal to 1. Therefore, you get the value of b and c to be minus 3 and 2 respectively. Therefore, the quadratic polynomial would be x square minus 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. The next example. Find all the roots of 2x to the power 4 minus 3x cube minus 3x square plus 6x minus 2. If it is given that two of its roots are root 2 and minus root 2. So this expression is equal to x minus a multiplied by x minus b if a and b are two roots, multiplied by x minus root 2 multiplied by x plus root 2. This implies to this expression is equal to x minus a into x minus b into x square minus 2. Let's divide this expression and you'll get x minus a into x minus b. On dividing, you get 2x square minus 3x plus 1, and this should be equal to x minus a into x minus b. You get this. You factorize this further, 2x square minus 3x plus 1, and you get 2x minus 1 into x minus 1. Therefore, the roots would be half, 1, root 2 and minus root 2. Let's move on to the next topic now, division of polynomials. Let's start by taking examples. Divide the polynomial 2x square plus 3x plus 1 by 2 plus x. The first step is arrange all the polynomials in the order of their degrees. So you sort this out and you get 2x square plus 3x plus 1. This has to be divided by x plus 2. In the second step, you divide the first term of the dividend. The dividend is 2x square plus 3x plus 1 by the first term of the divisor. What is the first term of divisor? It is x. And then you keep on solving like this. The step one would be the first term of the dividend is 2x square. Divide 2x square by the first term of divisor, that is x. So you get the quotient as 2x. Write that on top. This is how you start. You start by dividing the first term by the first term of divisor. Also multiply that by the second term of divisor, which is 2. Multiply 2 by 2x. You get 2x square plus 4x and you subtract that. Subtracting, you get minus x. Now in step 2, you carry this down, the remaining term plus 1. The first term of the dividend now is minus x. You divide minus x by the first term, that is x. You get minus 1 on top and then you multiply minus 1 by the second term of the divisor. Subtract that and you get the final remainder as plus 3. Your quotient comes out to be 2x minus 1 and your remainder would be plus 3. How do you know that 3 is the remainder? We stop when the degree of the resulting polynomial, this is the resulting polynomial at the end, plus 3, is lesser than the divisor. The degree of the divisor is 1 in x plus 2 and the degree of plus 3 is 0. Therefore, this is your remainder. This is how you express this. 2x square plus 3x plus 1 is equal to x plus 2 into 2x minus 1 plus 3. Let us take another example. Divide 3x cube plus x square plus 2x plus 5 by 1 plus 2x plus x square. The first thing, arrange them in the order of their degrees. Therefore, you have to divide 3x cube plus x square plus 2x plus 5 by x square plus 2x plus 1. Make the table for division. In step 1, you divide the first term of the dividend, which is 3x cube, by the first term of the divisor, which is x square. On dividing, you get 3x as the first term of the quotient. You start by dividing 3x cube by x square, and this 3x is to be multiplied by both the other terms of the divisor. Multiply 2x by 3x and 1 by 3x and you get 6x square plus 3x. You subtract this from the expression above and you get minus 5x square minus x plus 5. Now you repeat this in the second step. In step 2, you again divide the first term of the dividend, minus 5x square, by the first term of the divisor, which is x square. On dividing, you get minus 5 on top. Also multiply minus 5 by the other two terms, 2x and 1, and subtract this. In the resulting expression, 9x plus 10, the degree is lesser than the degree of the divisor. The degree of divisor is 2 and the degree of 9x plus 10 is 1. Therefore, this is your remainder. So finally, your quotient is 3x minus 5 and your remainder is 9x plus 10. Therefore, you can represent this as 3x cube plus x square plus 2x plus 5 is equal to x square plus 2x plus 1 multiplied by 3x minus 5 plus 9x plus 10. Let's take an example now. Find the values of a and b so that x to the power 4 plus x cube plus 8x square plus ax plus b is divisible by x square plus 1. For exact divisibility, the remainder should be 0. So what do? Just divide this polynomial by x square plus 1 and find the remainder. When you divide, the remainder comes out to be x multiplied by a minus 1 plus b minus 7. For remainder to be always 0, the coefficient of x should be 0 and the constant term should also be 0. Therefore, a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 7.